ओम श्री मात्रे नमः। नाउडेज एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन इंडिया इज नॉट अप टू द मार्क। जनरली पीपल नॉट नो व्हाट इज एजुकेशन। जनरली यूज्ड टू से एजुकेशन मीन स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम एलकेजी टू पीजी, रीडिंग बुक्स of curriculum is called education, going to school, going to college or universities, they acquire education. It is meant for the job oriented, it's not a true education, formal education, beneficial education, purpose oriented education. So, the purpose of education is true education. People do not know what is a true education. A person never gets 100% education only from school, only from teacher, or only self-education, only by friends. That's why in Sanskrit a quote is there, a person gets 100% by four ways. What is this? Acharyat padamadatte padam shishyah swametaya padam sabrahmacharibhyah padam kalakramenacha. A student can acquire 1/4 of knowledge by teacher, 1/4 of knowledge by his own intellectual, another 1/4 of knowledge by his mates, last 1/4 of knowledge by passing the time, days, etc. These four makes a person into 100% educated. Anyone is lapsed, he may not called 100% educated. Nowadays people are educated, we can say everywhere, but there is no proper implement of true education by the government. All are became commercial. True education teaches how to lead life, how to get not only money or wealth, health, but reputation. There should be individuality, self-discipline, self-respect. These three comes by true education only. It is lapsing to the children of nowadays. In olden days, the education was far better than these days education. There might not be technology, advanced technological education, computerized education, but the teacher taught the children true education to impart not only the knowledge of the books, even from various ways of going to library, going to educational tools and attending various moral ethical classes. In this way, the true education was implemented in olden days. That's why we can see the olden days people were, though they were based of 10th class, but they can write very well about the drafts. Nowadays you can see the students, they may be PG, but they are unable to write even letter. Why? Because only bookish knowledge. It should be changed. Unless we get true education, life is miserable. It should not be mechanical. Due to lack of true education, people are lack of peace of mind. That's why our Acharya Shankara, Ramanuja, Swami Vivekananda fought for importing true education. That's today I chose the topic of true education to analyze and to give you the details. Let us get the details of true education. జ్ఞానానందమయం దేవం నిర్మల స్ఫటికాకృతిం ఆధారం సర్వవిద్యానాం హయగ్రీవముపాస్మహే. We can get an additional abilities from true education, which is a combination of established structure of schooling and university education. Already we are existed from these. Combined with the equipping students with additional powers so that they can understand the different perspectives leading the diverse world and handle the problems intelligently and succeed without losing sight of human values at the same time. So, true education can also have another connotation, means suggestion, where formal education takes a back seat and self-education becomes a primary. Since education can also be self-initiated through choice or otherwise, Rabindranath Tagore, Mark Twain, William Blake, Maxim Gorky, George Bernard Shaw, Leonardo da Vinci, and many other such names are personalities who were self-taught. They are true educationalists. These personalities abdicated formal education in lieu of self-education, but as long as it served to accomplish their life goals and brought forth necessary skills for survival and eventual success, keeping humanitarian goals inside, in the mind, formality was never even a concern. Here are some of Nobel laureate Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore's thoughts on education, which may interest many of us. He was also the founder of Vishwa Bharati University, that follows a unique model of education. Formal education will make you a living, but self-education will make you a fortune. See the difference. A self-educated, gifted, firm and self-motivated person can emerge from stronger than a formally educated individual, as examples above confirmation. Nevertheless, within a formal setup, for that who can afford it, choose it and want their children to pursue it, textbook information and a traditional education culture are an important existing force. These tips, as pointed out above, are not complete in themselves. There are questions which need to be consequently asked and suggestions on other target teaching areas be periodically made, so that children and young adults are armed with more than textbook knowledge and are better prepared to face a challenging and evolving world. The idea is not to force any philosophy or methodology on anyone, but to create different sources of growth. These could be kept as optional courses for students to be stronger, more knowing and human individuals when they head out into the world beyond the boundaries of formal education. Let us see some viewpoints and suggestions on true education. Julie Hearn, an elegant author of many beautiful and interesting young adult fiction novels, has some personal experiences to share and excellent advice to give regarding true education. What she says, most of what I learned in school in order to pass exams, I can no longer recall. My true education came from the books I borrowed from the library, from stories that flooded my imagination, animated my soul, and taught me unforgettable truths about the business of being alive. I believe now more than ever that the most important room in any school, in any part of the world, is still a library, and that fiction, especially contemporary fiction written about and for children, plays a vital role in equipping young people with some of the psychosocial and interpersonal skills that can make the journey through life less bumpy. It is the books that children read for pleasure that important, the most valuable lessons. When young readers connected with a character in a story, when they follow that character through all manner of crises and see how that character copes them, or learning life skills vicariously. A story tackling, for example, peer pressure and drug abuse in an intelligent, engaging and accessible way can shape a young reader's attitudes and promote healthy life choices more efficiently than my lecture. Giving young people opportunities to express themselves creatively without restrictions is something else I feel strongly about. There is much enforced conformity within the education system and too many boxes to tick. The UK-based charity First Story supports and inspires literacy, creativity and confidence by placing established writers in challenging UK schools. Dr. D. Mukherjee, associated professor at the School of Social Work, Southern Illinois University, shares some sharp and perceptive views on the topic. He says, I am a believer in education. Education can be divided into two parts. One is teaching specific skills sets. This is structured and is designed from classroom teaching and learning, which happens between the teachers and students. It provides a basic orientation to students, as in mathematics, history, and geography. The second part of education concerns its dynamics areas. This is a top-down approach. It is not created and is completely unmonitored. Like, for example, meditation. It is not imposed, but could have elements of growth for a human life. The results of this are difficult to measure. For example, Ivy League students may not necessarily to be great critical thinkers, although they may have been educated quite skillfully. Individuals issue justice, set down rights without thinking critically. This will not work. It is important to have a well-rounded personality. It is essential that when trying to design a curriculum, in addition to setting patterns and giving instructions, make it dynamic too. There are some schools where there are no playgrounds, no craft sections, nothing like guitar classes, karate classes, places where the child can have some free time and can be totally unsupervised. Structured education is entirely formal, and this cultural of tutorials on its own is not sufficient. The Wall Street disaster happened because corporate ethics was missing. Since then, a class on corporate ethics has become compulsory in the US. Formally educated folks who do not have standards and values could also lead to fascism and dictatorship. We need to have a balance. There needs to be a combination of structured education and dynamic and active spaces. In these spaces, ensure children's safety, but leave them on their own for some time. Let them figure it out. We don't always learn in linear patterns. Sometimes kids learn from other kids. Only structured patterns will not create critical thinkers and truly educated personalities. Philosophy should be included. Reading habit should be inculcated. The regular education system is exploitative in nature because of set structures of making. In India, we need innovators like Steve Jobs, not a garage culture. Students are scared of bunking classes. There is hardly any scope for finance, creative writing, or other specialized for students in India. School curriculum is not completely virtuous, it is influenced. The education system should expose all kinds of contradictory views, but set patterns are followed so that we can control people's views. Multiple ideas and knowledge should be put forward for students to learn from. Knowledge is waiting to be disputed and disproven. It is not to be cramped. Don't try to kill variety, to compare and contrast at the same time. Nobody wants to debate. People want ready-made knowledge. This needs to change. Parents speak. A few concerned parents, especially observant mothers of young children from various cities, had the following suggestion to make, which they felt could be incorporated within the formal education or organizations, mainly schools. They share, it is a good idea to offer a wide variety of co-curriculum or co-curricular activities in schools. The exposure allows the kids to explore various options and see if they are passionate about it or not. A good teacher or a mentor can breathe life into a program, and on the contrary, a bad teacher totally defeats the purpose. Meditation has miraculous benefits, and if the kids are introduced to it at an early age, it may work wonders in making the journey of life smoother. Educating children about the importance of healthy eating is also important where child obesity is on the rise. Small acts that show resilience, persistence, integrity, empathy, or honesty should also be rewarded so as to encourage children to be nice. Bullying in schools is also needs to be checked by creating awareness and implementing strong disciplinary consequences if children are found to bully others, as it leaves a lasting impression on tender minds. Indian schooling at an early age should inculcate more of a play-based learning, more involvement in curricular activities from the beginning, such as sports, music, and all the arts, so that the kids can develop those crucial skills they need to succeed in life, both professionally and personally. There should be more emphasis on the child's development instead of competition and comparison. There should be an introduction of a few optional foreign languages for children to choose from. Teachers are responsible for imparting knowledge, so their experience and skills should be evaluated well before they are in the role. Life is manifold. It is unpredictable and truly extempore. To have the ability to manage life in the best possible manner, it is vitally necessary to not depend only on structured education, but to bring more flexibility to it through a consensus between responsible authorities, successful individuals from around the world who wish to contribute, representation from parents and families as well, and most importantly, keeping the interest of children in mind. Other forms of education like open education, e-learning and alternative education have also emerged, and positives from these should also be used to benefit children everywhere. A gradual change should be allowed to take place where the best education possible is provided to children. Education is also a matter of choice and affordability. There are individuals who can't afford any kind of formal education at all. For them, true education comes from experiences and skills they gain from life, and several cases they find immense success. In terms of selections and authorities, following the philosophy of to each his own, some decisions and choices on education methods to be pursued are made by parents or children themselves, some early, some later, some are given circumstances and the will to follow through. Whether track is chosen, it should be possible from life and give back to the community as well. Education is the most powerful weapon we can use to it change the world. It is a saying, but in today's context it's losing its charm. A word education we come across every day several times. It means acquiring knowledge by learning. Now a very important question arises, that how do we learn? We learn from our day-to-day experiences. When we analyze any situation, especially students, their creativity, thinking develops eventually. It leads to overall development of students. Now, most of you would say, no, we learn from our books of physics, maths, history, and many more, but that is not learning. That is cramming. This is what most of the students are doing today. Yes, it is necessary to study books for getting a job, but not enough to live meaningful and valuable life. We simply read our books, get good marks. What about our moral and ethical values, human values? That is missing in today's education to the students. They are not even distinguished between what is right and wrong. A person left his old parents in old age home, and he was having a number of degrees, can we say that he is educated? No. True education is beyond earning degrees. It is more than bookish knowledge. Education means inculcating moral values, positive thinking, attitude of helping, attitude of giving to society, and ethical values. These kind of students are only able to bring changes in society. They will become good citizens of country. And most important one, good human being. Such students are able to discover something new, but breaking. They will surely become successful in their life. It happens educated in true sense when if they are. Many people confuse with knowledge. Education, at least in a country like ours, is when you have a basic qualification, earn a degree, and can accordingly meet the requirements needed to work in a job. In our country, education is more about elimination than selection. The cream layer is selected among tens of thousands of candidates, and it is them who make it to the top of the ladder. And what about the rest? They have to be content with whatever they have and are branded as average. Only those who can survive this rat race are considered to be smart. Bad luck. This flavored view of what education really is exists in our country and many others too. But there is a lot more to education than just attending school, passing exams, attending university, and getting a degree. Education is a holistic process. It is not just about earning degrees. It is about the values and life lessons you imbibe in the process. It is about exploring the unknown and about having the thirst to learn more than what is required of your exam. It is about hands-on learning. Education is about gaining practical knowledge and also should equip you to use your intelligence and capability to face real-life situations. True education is a culmination of classwork and experience. It all begins with the fundamentals. The foundation of true education is the ability to grasp all concepts taught to oneself and then put into one's own perspective. In other words, to be taught to learn. True education function is to teach us to think intensively and to think critically. Like Martin Luther King once said, provides a perfect example of what true education should strive for. True education should begins in the classroom, then moves to a personal experience and practice. True education brings about consciousness. Consciousness brings about revolution. Revolution brings about change. Change is the law of nature. Law is a code of conduct. Thus, education without consciousness has no meaning at all. Education is a lifelong process. We learn as long as we live. We live to learn, but we must learn to live. The traditional wisdom of India never separated learning from living. There is no yardstick for the examination paper, more so making systems vary from institution to institution. The examination is not the balance of knowledge. The examination pattern in our country is not uniform. Education is in the concurrent list of our constitution. There is growing disparity between the state-sponsored educational institutions and private educational institutions. Growing privatization of education and commercialization of education has converted education into an industry without its welfare objectives and immediate production orientation, which is accessible to very few corrupt people. Lack of true education and self-control leads to corruption. Corruption is a result of lack of consciousness and conscience, lust for money, power and position, and materialistic gains with the degeneration of moral values. corrupt tendencies turn into corrupt practices and habits owing to the prevailing ills of society, unequal distribution of land, labor and capital, unequal adjustment of economy and society, and all the free market economic competition, inhuman ways of making money, maximization of profits, to urge to possess assets by unfair means, maintenance of the status quo, craze for power to dominate over the powerless and masses. These are all due to lack of true education. That's why we should give importance for true education. I think now you might have understood what is the difference between formal education and true education. श्रीकांताय कल्याण निधि निधेदना श्रीवेंकटनिवासाय श्रीनिवासाय मंगलम मंगलाशासन प्रेमदाचार्य पुरोगमी सर्वेश पूर्वैराचार्ये सत्कृतायास्तु मंगलम।